Andy here. We have more spoilers for day 8 of Modern Horizons. Let's see what more spoilers we have for today. I have already showed you the card of the day, the spoiler of the day. I couldn't wait to group everything together because it was a very, very big surprise and a very big spoiler. I'm talking about Yawgmoth. Yes, Yawgmoth was spoiled for Modern Horizons. Yawgmoth, the arch enemy of Erza, he was spoiled. Both two characters, both two legendary creatures, are going to be in this set in Modern Horizons. They are both pre planeswalkers. They are both card strong, and I'm sure they will be going up in price. Let's see what more was spoiled for Modern Horizons today. We have some new slivers. We have two common slivers. Bladeback sliver, one and one red. It's a 2/2 sliver. It has Hellbend. Hellbend means that as long as you have no cards in your hand, slivers you control have tap. This creature deals 1 damage to target player or planeswalker. Enduring Sliver, 1 and 1 white, it's a 2/2 sliver. It has Outlast. It has Outlast 2, means that if you pay 2 you and tap, you put a +1/+1 counter on this creature. Outlast only as a sorcery. Other slivers you control have Outlast 2. Ingenious Infiltrator, 2, 1 blue, 1 black. It's a 2/3 ninja. It has ninjutsu for 1 blue and 1 black. Ninjutsu is a mechanic from the block of Kamigawa quite some time ago. I haven't seen this mechanic. It means that if that you have an unblocked creature, attacking creature, you can pay the ninjutsu cost, that is 1 blue, 1 black, return that creature to your hand and put Ingenious Infiltrator instead of that creature. Whenever a ninja you control deals combat damage to a player, you draw a card. Nantuko Cultivator, 3 and 1 green, it's a 2/2 insect druid. When it enters the battlefield, you may discard any number of lands cards, put that many +1/+1 counters on Nantuko, and draw that many cards. In Modern Horizons, we are seeing a lot of mechanics and abilities that will let you put or discard land from your hand into your graveyard. That means that cards like Crucibles of Word will be an excellent combination with this type of cards. Goblin Oriflame, 1 and 1 red. It's an enchantment. Attacking creatures you control gain +1/+0. Webweaver Changeling, 3 and 2 green. It is a changeling. That means that this creature is every creature type. That means that this can be also a sliver. And remember that sliver give ability to other slivers. It's a 3/5. It has reach. When it enters the battlefield, if there are 3 or more creature cards in your graveyard, you gain 5 life. Valiant Changeling, 5 and 2 white, it's a 7 cost, casting cost. It's a 3/3 creature. It has Changeling, it has double strike, but the spell costs 1 less to cast for each creature type among creatures you control. This effect can reduce the amount of mana the spell costs by more than 5. You can imagine how strong this card can be if you have all creature types on the battlefield. Hall of Heliot's Generosity, it's a legendary land. You tap for 1 colorless or 1 waste, depends how you want to see that symbol. For 1 and 1 white, you tap, you put target enchantment cards from your graveyard on top of your library. It's a nice enchantment retrieval that you can put an enchantment from your graveyard on top of your library and then draw it. Last card I'm going to show you today, Kaya's Jewel, for one white and one black. It's an instant. It's a very, very strong instant. You choose to. Each opponent sacrifice a creature. Exile all cards from each opponent's graveyard. Create a 1/1 white or black spirit creature token with flying. You gain 4 life. It has Entwine 3. That means that for the 3 casting cost, you choose 2 of them. If you choose the Entwine, that is a 6 cost, you will choose all 4 abilities. This is the last card I'm going to show you today. Stay tuned to my channel, because as I said, and as I always promise, I'm going to keep covering all spoilers for Modern Horizons.